Hello IP students. Today our topic is MySQL, and in this lecture we are going to discuss one of the most important command used in MySQL, that is select statement, in detail. I already give some example related to select and the clause that are used with select statement, such as a where clause, like clause, etc. But in this video we are going to discuss a select statement in detail. So let's start first. As you know that select is basically a DML statement, and when we talk about the DML statement, it clearly indicates that if we want to manipulate data, then the command that are used to manipulate the data are called the DML statements, and select is one of those. So using select statement, you are able to show the data in your SQL. So first of all, what you have to do, just write select after that column name of any table which you want to show on your screen, and then from keyword, and then after table name. In this way you are able to show the result related to a particular table. Using select statement, it is possible that we select a particular portion of the table or entire table. So first of all, the one of the most important thing and the simple thing is that if you want to select the data related to a particular column, then just mention these column names only. And if you want to select the entire data without any condition, then just write select star. Star means all. So in this way you are able to select the entire data of your database or of your table that you select. So first of all, you have to select a database, and then use the then write the command use that database. Suppose if you want to work in the database prev, then just like use prev. And if you just forget the name of the database, then for that purpose there is a command name show database. So first of all, just write show database. It gives you a clear idea that how many databases are there, and you can create your own database and you can use existing database also. MySQL is the default database available in MySQL. So now you are able to create a table in particular database. When you just create a different tables in a particular database, now the time to access the data of that table. So for that purpose, there is a command name select statement that you can use. So the command is very simple. Just write select column name 1, column name 2, comma column name n. If there are n columns, then you can select any number of columns up to n from after that table name. So that is the syntax of that select statement. For example, before going to discuss some example related to MySQL, there is another thing. If you want to select all columns, then write star. Select star from table name. Instead of writing any column name, just write star. So select star from table name. That is a second, and that is also a syntax of MySQL. So the you have two ways to select the columns. If you want to select a particular column or a group of column, just name those column after the select statement. So select column name, and then after from, and then table name. And if you want to select all columns, then just write select star from table name. Now this is a table, as you can see in the screen, which contain basically 5 columns: ID, name, age, address, salary. These are the 5 columns here. And if you just write select ID, name, salary from customer, then answer look like this. This is the answer display on your screen. Now you can easily see that original table contain 5 different column name, but here we just select 3 different columns: ID, name, and salary. So information related to 3 different columns are visible here only, and rest 2 are not visible because here we just select a particular portion of our table. Next, if you just write select star from customer, then complete data regarding to table customer will be displayed on your screen. As you see in this example, ID, name, address, salary, complete data is visible here. So that is all about select statement. So using select statement, first of all, you are able to select a column or a group of column or the entire column with all records. So this is the simplest way, but if you want to filter the records or if you want to apply the condition on certain records, then for that purpose there is a clause used that is called as where clause. Okay, so a where clause is used to filter records first of all, and the where clause is used to extract only those records that fulfill a specific criteria. And the where clause is not only used in select statement, but is also used in update and delete statement. So one of the most important things is that we can use where clause with select as well as with update and delete statement also. Now the syntax is very simple. First of all, just write the command as usual, as we just write the select statement normally. Then after the table name, we can give the condition, and condition, for giving a condition you must use where clause. So then our syntax is like that: select column name 1, column name comma, column name 2, comma, column name n from table name, and where condition. Okay, now let us see an example here. First of all, there is a table named customers, contain 5 different columns: ID, name, age, address and salary. Now if you want to filter the records in it, suppose you want to show only those records or details of only those customers who have salary greater than 2000. Okay, so for that purpose we just write select ID, name, salary. If you want to select a particular column or a group of columns, then name those columns after select. And if you want to select all columns, then you can use star. So here I want to show only 3 columns: name, ID, name and salary. So I just write ID, name and salary. Then keyword from, after that table name is customers, after that where, and then salary is greater than 2000. So that is a condition. So that condition applied, and after that condition there are only 4 records that are shown on the screen, and that is the output. Okay, so what happens that whatever you just apply the condition with where clause, that condition, according to that condition, data will be displayed. So now that is a complete syntax of the select statement. Using select statement, you are able to select different columns, and it is also possible that if you want to filter records, then condition is given with where records, given with where clause. And if you just don't write a where clause in your select statement, then all records will be selected by default. So now you have 2 options: you have to select a particular column and you have to select particular records. To select particular column, so just the name, the mention their name after select. And if you want to filter records according to certain condition, then always use where clause. Now again, see an example here. I just write select ID, comma, name, comma, salary from customers, where name is equal to Hardik. There is a gap between customers and where. Customer is the name of table. Okay, so if I just want to see the record of Hardik related to column name ID, name and salary, then I just write select ID, comma, name, comma, salary, and from customers, customers is the name of the table, where name is equal to Hardik. Then all details related to Hardik will be displayed on your screen. Next is and an or operator. So sometimes what happens that there are more than 2 conditions, and you want to show the records according to the according to that conditions. So the conditions can be separated by 2 operators. These are and operator and or operator. And operator and or operator. When we separate the condition using and operator, then the result that is displayed basically satisfy both the conditions. But when the condition is separated by or statement or operator, then if any condition is found to be true, that record will be displayed on a screen. So that is the difference between the and the or. And means both, and or means any one condition. So it is all depend on you that how you separate the condition. You can separate the condition using and using or. So that is the syntax on a screen: select column name 1, comma column name 2, comma column name n, n columns are there. From table name, we have condition, and after condition 1, just write keyword AND, and condition 2. So these are the different conditions. To separate two condition, we can use AND, and if there are three condition, we use AND between the conditions. As you can see in screen, condition 1 AND, condition 2, after AND, condition N, such a way. So now again, there is a table name customers, and which have a 5 column: ID, name, age, address, salary. Okay. If the condition is that a salary must be greater than 2000 and age of the customer is less than 25, so we want to show only that data of the customer who have salary greater than 2000 and who have age less than 25. So we just write select ID, name, and salary. ID, name, and salary are the name of the columns. And if you want to select all columns, then just write select star, and then from and name of the table is customers, and where clause is after, just after that. Now we have two conditions: salary must be greater than 2000, age it must be less than 25, and we are going to select only those rows who or records who satisfy both these conditions. So we separate these condition by AND operator. We just write AND. Now you can easily see that only two records are found: Komal 4500 and Monica 10,000. Let us see the original table. You can easily see that. First of all, according to the condition, age must be less than 25. Okay, so the age which are less than 25: Kangna, Komal, and Monica. Three records are found. And second is you can easily see here. Salary must be greater than 2000. Okay, so salary greater than 2000, Kangna is not considered here because age is less than 25, but salary is exactly 2000. And here we want to show the records where salary greater than 2000. So Kangna will not be selected in this case. And again, Komal is less than 25. Okay, that's okay. And salary also greater than 2000. So this row, this record, also selected in that case. And then Monica, age is less than 25 found, again okay. And income or salary is greater than 2000 here, actually it is a 10,000. So last two records will be our answer, because these two records satisfy both the conditions. Now you can easily see that, but here entire record will not be displayed because we select only three column: ID, name, and salary. So information related to ID, name, and salary will be selected who satisfy the condition salary greater than 2000 and age must be less than 25. Next is OR operator. OR operator basically provides a choice between different conditions. If any one condition is found to be true, then result will be displayed. So that is the basic difference between AND and OR. With AND operator, there is a compulsion to satisfy the all the conditions which are separated by AND, but using OR operator, there is a choice between different conditions. If any condition is found to be true, then record related to that condition will be displayed on a screen. Now same example is here. We again select ID, name, salary from customers, where salary must be greater than 2000 and age is less than 25, but we separate this condition by using OR operator. Last time there are only two records which we found. Now this time you can easily see that we have five records. And why we have five records? Because certain records found to be true in that case in which age is less than 25, and certain records where salary is greater than 2000 is true, found to be true. So when any record fulfill the condition salary greater than 2000 or age less than 25 will be displayed on a screen. So that is the basic difference between AND and OR operator. Next is like clause. Like clause is already discussed in my previous lecture. Now I think it is clear to all of you. So I just give a quick revision of the like clause here. Like clause is used where we don't exactly know the data or know the condition. So we then in that circumstances we use like clause. And like clause is used with two wildcard characters, that is percentage and underscore. So as you can see in screen, the like clause, the like operator is used to where with in a where clause to search for a specific pattern. To search for a specific pattern. So it is used for pattern searching. And okay, and the SQL like clause is used to compare a value to similar value using wildcard operators. And these are there are two wildcard used in conjunction with like operator. These are percentage sign and the underscore. The percent sign represent 0, 1 or multiple characters, and the underscore represent a single number or a character, and the symbol can be used in combination. So the underscore represent a single number of character and the symbol can be used in combination. And these are some examples of like clause here. First is select star from table via column name like XXXX percentage. It simply means that all those values are selected which are start with XXXX, and after that there may be any string, or it may or if there is no string then it will also be selected, because as you know that a wildcard character percentage is used for 0 or more than 0 more than 0 characters. So if there is no character at all, that will also be considered, but first 4 characters should be XXXX, and after that there may be any string, or it is possible there may be no string. In second case, select star from table name where column like percentage XXXX. So it simply means that a string will start with any character or any group of character. After that there are 4 characters XXXX, and after that there may be any string. Next is select star from table name where column like XXXX and underscore. Now in this case there is a compulsion that a string should contain 5 characters, and which 4 characters are fixed at position 1, 2, 3 and 4. Means initial 4 position are fixed here, and after that 5th position there is maybe any character. Next case, you can easily see that select star from table name where column like underscore XXXX. It simply means that there are 5 characters in which at first position there may be any character, but at second, third, fourth and fifth position there is a character X. So X should be there. And in last case, you can easily see that select star from table name where column name like underscore XXXX underscore. It means that a string should be of size 6 character. Okay. At first place there may be any character, and at sixth place there may be any character, and between first and sixth there are 4 characters that are fixed, and these are XXXX. Now these are the some examples here which basically show the use of like clause. So suppose in a table customer we just write where Sally like 200%. It simply means that all Sally will be selected who have initial 3 digit 200. In next case, where Sally like percentage 200%. It means Sally maybe start with any digit or any group of digits are there at the starting position. After that 200 must be there, and after 200 there may be any set of digits, or it may be possible there may be no digit at all, because percentage wildcard characters means 0 or 0 or null or more than null. It means at least a single digit will be there. So when we just like percentage 200%, it means at the place of percentage there may be a digit, or it is possible there is no digit at all, okay, or there is a group of digit also, and after that 200 will be there, and after that there is a percentage sign again. It means there may be digit or there may be no digit at all, or there may be any group of digit. Next is where Sally like underscore 00. It simply means that at the place of underscore there must be a digit, and it gives a clear idea that Sally must be in three digit, okay, in which first digit may be any number, but second and third digit are fixed and these are 0 and 0. Means Sally look like as a 900, or it may be 100, okay. Next is where Sally like 2%%%. It simply means that Sally must always start with digit 2. After that there may be any digit. After that there may be any group of digits. After that there is any digit, and after that there may be any group of digit. So simply means that when underscore is there, it means there is a missing of a single digit, and where there is percentage there, it means there is a missing of a group of digit, or it is also possible that there is no digit at all. So percentage means any string, and underscore means a single digit or a character should be there. In this case digit must be there. Next case, where Sally like percentage 2, it means any string but ends with 2. In next case, where Sally like underscore 202 percentage 3, it simply means that that Sally start with any number, but the second number must be 2. After that there is maybe any string, and it end always with 3. And in last case, 2 underscore 3, it means first digit must be 0, last digit must be 3, and between those two digits there may be any digit. Next is order by clause. Order by clause is basically used to sort the data in ascending or descending order, and it is always used by the after that it is always used with select statement. And as you know that select statement is look like the select column name 1, column name 2 from table name, and after that we can give order by clause. So after order by, we can give any column name. According to that we just want to sort our data or manage our data in ascending or descending order. And if there are two columns or more than two columns, it simply means that first of all data will be sorted according to the first column, and if value are found to be same according to the first column, then data will be sorted according to the second column. And if by default data will be in ascending order using order by clause, and if you want to make the data in descending order, use DESC keyword after giving the column name. By default ascending order is there, but if you want to use ascending order intentionally, then you can use ASC keyword also. So here the example you can see here, customer table is again here with 5 column names: ID, name, age, address and salary. And if you just write select star from customers, order by name and salary, so this data will be selected according to the name here, okay, ID, name, age, address, salary. So data will be according to the name, and if name is found to be same, then data will be sorted according to the salary. Next is order by name, but in descending order. So data is in descending order. You can easily see that select star from customer, order by name, DESC. The data will be in descending order because DESC keyword is used here. Now in operator. So the in operator allows you to specify multiple values in a where clause. So if you want to allow specify multiple values in a where clause, then you can use in operator. So the syntax is select column names from table name, where column name, and then in, and then different values, value 1, value 2, value 3, up to so on. For example, if you want to select a address and you can use in operator, just like that, select star from customer where address in Delhi, Kota and or Bhopal. Delhi, Kota, comma Bhopal is there. So there are three addresses. So three addresses there. So only the address which belongs to only these three values will be selected in that case. That is the use of in operator. So we use in operator to select a value out of a group of value or a pool of values. So after in, we give a group of values. In this case, there are three values, Delhi, Kota and Bhopal. So we select only those values which belongs to the Delhi, Kota or Bhopal. So the advantage of any operator is that basically in operator reduce our work as compared to OR operator. Instead of separate different condition using OR operator, we just give in operator and provide a group of values here. Now this is the output, you can easily see on the screen. So we can easily see there, see here that the data which belongs to the Delhi, Kota or Bhopal is visible only, and rest of the data is not visible. Next is SQL between operator. So the SQL between operator select the values within a given range, and the value can be a number, text or dates, and the value and the between operator is inclusive, means begin and the end values are included. And the syntax will look like this: select columns name from table name, after that where column name between value 1 and value 2. So when there is a big range or there is a much more values, then we don't use in operator. Instead of we use between operator when we just want to select a value from a given range. So the main point regarding to the between clause is that between is inclusive, means both values, start and end values, both are included in this case. So in this case, when you just write where column name between value 1 and value 2, it means value 1 and value 2 both are included, as well as the value between that lies between value 1 and value 2 all are included in that case. So for example, there is a table name customer, and if you just write select star from customers where age between 25 and 30, it simply means that employee who have age 25 or who have age 30 or who have age between 25 and 30 all are selected in that case. It means age 25 is selected, employees who have age 30s will also be selected, employee who have age 26, 27, 28, 29 will also be selected in that case. So you can easily see here that this is the output. When you see the original table, that is our original table, and you can easily see that the age lies between 25 and 30 first one, and then Kishan, and then Hardik. So three rows are only selected regarding to Rupali, Kishan and Hardik. Kangna must be there. Okay. This is a Kishan, Rupali, Hardik. Okay, Kishan, Rupali, Hardik. So this is the result related to between operator. Now this is our today's now I think you are able to understand all the basic concept of the MySQL. Now all SQL commands, many SQL commands are over here. So in our next video, we will discuss its practical implementation. Thanks for watching this video.